Balancing a job with family life can hold back women hoping to climb the corporate ladder. A new study reported by the New York Times blames a culture of overwork for hurting women's chances of success. Researchers found the demand for longer work hours affects both genders, but for women, who are often the primary caregivers at home, the burden is greater. If they turn to their company's flex time for help, they face career setbacks. Harvard Business School professor Robin Ely co-authored the study. Robin, good morning.
Good morning.
So what surprised you? What led you to conduct this study?
Well, we were actually invited by the firm to come in and help them to understand why they were having difficulty advancing women into their partnership. And so they thought it might have something to do with their culture, ways that they were inadvertently blocking women. Mm-hmm. And so they asked us to come in and study the culture, which we did. And one of the things that we found was that when we asked people, what do you think is the reason for women's stalled advancement, most people gave some version of the work-family narrative that you just gave, that the work demands a 24/7 availability, and that women, but not men, are unable to meet that demand, and that's why they're not advancing. So,
what'd you find?
Well, what we found was something a little different from that. First of all, we found that men were as likely as women to be suffering from the competing pulls of work and family. And we also found that some people were working a lot of hours, but they weren't necessarily productive hours. And mm-hmm. So that's why we call it a culture of overwork. So there were a lot of norms in the firm, and I don't think this was an unusual firm. For example, to be available constantly 24/7 for a client, to produce an absolutely perfect work product when the client doesn't really need perfection.
Mm-hmm. So what did the firm do with this results that you discovered?
They had a hard time taking it in. They thought maybe we hadn't talked to the right people, mm-hmm. maybe we hadn't collected enough data. And they really had a hard time hearing it, and I think that that's really just further evidence of how deeply rooted the belief is that we, A, need to work these hours in order to be productive, and B, that women are the ones and not men who are unable to meet that demand. They were really looking to us for a solution that would address the women problem, that would really address something that was specifically up for women. And we said, no, actually, the issue seems to be much broader. It seems to be an issue, as I said, of overwork, and that you really need to change the way you work, be more efficient, recognize that men are also having these struggles, and
why isn't the emphasis on productivity? I mean, if you talk to a lot of moms, they say that they'll get feedback as they try for promotions. Well, you're not here as long, and you usually leave at a certain hour because you have to go home because you're a mom.
Right.
And moms react that way to sort of like, I thought I was judged on the productivity of my work or actually doing my job. So why does that bias still exist?
Well, I think there's still a strong belief that FaceTime is important, that if you look like you're working and available 24/7, that you are a really committed worker, that you're devoted to work. And
so how does this change then? I mean, it just doesn't seem like there's a solution here.
The question is how flex time, or whatever you define as flex time, how that changes, right?
Yeah, well, flex time, is her study says that it hurts women more because they ask for less time and then they get judged even further, right?
Well, the problem with flex time isn't with flex time per se, but with the fact that it is primarily women who use flex time. Mm-hmm. And, you know, men deal with the problem differently. They either suffer in silence or they do these kind of workarounds. They don't necessarily. What we found also in this firm, in another paper by one of my colleagues, Aaron Reed, is that some of the most productive men, the highest rated men in terms of, their performance, were not necessarily available 24/7, but they were flying under the radar.
That's interesting.
So the bottom line here is you got to look at the way we work.
Absolutely. Yes.
Robin, thank you very much.